from the old French canal from 1879. Looking in the new canal lock, so it's on the port side, and they're gigantic and huge. So it's passed to the right, present. When you get into the locks, they're gigantic. Do you realize we could put three Titanics inside the
top lock? If you're looking at it from deck 14 or 15, you can see it sailing out into the third largest man-made lake in the world, Panama Canal. She's down there on deck 10. You're all going to get the chance to enjoy that moment. You used to have 6 models of 6 locks. With 6 yellow, really was, you know, super. 1998, we went to computers. 43 on the starboard side of what was hell. They have to work in tandem. There has to be 2 at a time. Both on the port side balconies, the 2 threaded camera prices. Now I can see the restitution plan and it's still there. If you want to see history, this is the largest earthen dam on the right. And the spillway in the center, William Seibert, Major William Seibert, who is the commander of the Atlantic Division. He built 2 giant 80-foot dancing cranes on either side of these locks. And has 8-ton buckets of wet cement making back and forth across to allow the construction. He decided that everything was going fine, so after 5 years of building the cement, he decided to really need iron bars, and just made by trying to build these blocks. They were 36 feet long, 12 feet high, 12 feet wide. Now you're inside the lock. You people back in the sanctuary can see the meter gates closing behind the island princess. That was a good picture. She smiled at us. There are all 3 captains coming at me right now.
The dam has built a special size. Building the wall behind the dam took 3 years. It was an amazing process. And it was on both sides.
Now they're just starting to let some of the water out of the lock in front of you. Remember, it takes 26 million gallons of fresh water to get us up these 2 steps. And when we come back out this afternoon, 26 million gallons, we come back out. This wind went. We went underneath the island fences and you did the other thing. For now, folks, on deck 10 and 11, see the old handrails in front of you on the meter gates? When those handrails go down, the gates are going to open. There's only 1 set of gates in front of you in this lock. When we get further up, we'll
find 2 sets of locks.
This is the best part of the Panama Canal right now, seeing all 3 captains on the bridge. Okay, back to business. The water is all the way down in the 2nd step in front of us. Now I want you to watch the yellow handrail. The gates, the meter gates have gone in place, and we are going forward. Captain Antonio is planning to stick on the other side of the bridge.
path is a little slack coming, it's moving very slowly. Nothing has been done fast here in Panama. You can feel the island that just inching forward. Notice the slack that takes up in the cables. Soon, all eight locomotives will move forward to keep up with the ship. See, it's a spring now. We're tethered to these locomotives, and they keep us between 19 and 26 inches from the concrete. Those two boats have changed direction.
No,
there's 26 pound meters down below. Show you're from Panama as well, posted. First engineer, Charles Findlay Wallace, lasted 8 months. He brought two metal coffins and his wife here, but he got fired by William Howard Taft. Gatun.
Look at the front window of the bus. The next 2 years the bus is still in the bottom of the building. And then at the bottom station of all the buses. Uh-huh.
gone for the expanded locks. There's a sludge barge being unloaded by two backhoes, putting the sludge onto a conveyor belt. And if you notice, the conveyor going from the other end of the canal at the Centennial Bridge. Where we're going to the entrance, you'll be able to see the actual divide where the three giant locks are going to be poured later on next year. Those will be completed by 2014. And this side of the Pacific side is closing to the sign of 6.